Hi there, welcome back to Barry tutorial series. In a previous lecture we saw that how to set up and run a Barry project. In this lecture, in this tutorial, we are going to see folder structure for the Barry project. It is a very important part to understand the project structure because it helps you to create your own project. So let's dive in. So there is, let me focus first what we have in our mind when we design the structure. We try to keep folder structure as a centralized, as a single source of truth, which means that all the components are at the one places, all the views are at the one places, all the extended control are at the one places, all the theme customization are at the one places. Also, it's the consistent, like folder name and file name are the consistent, so that it's better for the readability. And last but not least, it's very easy to edit. So let me dive in to the code itself. So this is the folder structure. This build folder, as we saw in the last tutorial, this build folder is used for the production build. This node module is being used internally while you are working on the development mode. Further, this public is the basic index.html file for your favicon and title and all those stuff. Our main folder is src. I'll come into that after reviewing all other things. This gitignore will use to ignore files from your git. It's not necessary that you have you are also using the git. We have used prettier for the formatting, and all the configuration is being saved here. How spacing is being managed, how width is being managed, is it single quoted, is it chroma, kind of that thing. Package.json consists all the package that we have using, dependencies and other things. This is a readme file. Web.config is unnecessary, so let me delete it. And web.config is only used if you are going to use deploy application in the IIS, but we are not deploying in the IIS. And this is yarn.log. So this file will automatically generate when if you are using yarn package manager. And if you are not using yarn package manager, instead of you are using package npm, then package.package.json.log will be used. So let me go into the source folder, which is most important. As you can see, we have a mock APIs, assets, concepts, and couple of things. I'll mostly focus on the folders which are specific to themes. Some of the folders are related to hooks or React core libraries. So I'll not give more focus into that one. So this mock APIs, it consists the fake call to the APIs. For instance, if we are using any live data, if you want to use any live data, but in this environment, we are not using any live application server. So for that, we have faked those things. Like if you are in the chat application, a data will came from here, like this users and all that stuff. So it will be a real calls. Whenever user do make an API call, like API chat users or API chat user ID, it will return data from here. So in your production environment, you just need to do a real call here instead of fake calls, and your data will render. It's so easy to manage, so easy to replace with your production servers or production APIs. Same as other mail, user profile, account, calendar, all are the fake datas. We have been managed in the mock APIs folder. Next is the assets. Assets we are managing for the CSS, SCSS, and the images. There are a bunch of images that we have been using, but all the images are very structured here. Like whatever images is being used in the authentication pages or card or documentation or languages, icons, everything will be managed in the separate folder. So it's very easy to replace if you want to do that. Further, we are using SCSS, whatever variables that being used for the color combination, we have put it in the one file. If you see, we have also commented out very clearly that how it is being used. These are the primary, secondary, and success color, kind of that thing. In the JavaScript file, we cannot use those colors directly. So we have made a JSON object here out of these variables. So you can have facility to use in JavaScript file as well. This is the styles that has been used over the material UI. You can make a customization according to your requirement here. This is the React context, and this is the React hooks. So those are the React concepts. If you are using this thing, then you may have prior knowledge to React itself. So I'm not going to deep dive into that one. Next folder is the layout. We have three layouts here. One is the minimal layout, second is the main layout, and third is the customization. So the main layout is consists the layout when once you logged in. Once you logged in and you see entire theme, that is the main layout. So if I run the application, let me start it side by side so that we can see it in the live as well. So it will run. In the meantime, we'll move on to the minimal layout. Minimal layout is the basic structure. If you want to apply in your project, you can do it anytime. This is the scroller. We have created a component for the scroll for the effects. So this is the layout. This customization layout is used for the feature. I'll show you how it is being used once the project is loaded in my local machine. So let's wait. Yeah, so this is the main layout that I was talking about. The entire layout, like this header section and this left section and this content section, are the part of the head main layout. Alright, and the customization layout is this. We have used the customization menu here to change the modes like light to dark, and change the font family, and change the border radius for the controls, and if you want to filled text box or not. That kind of feature or customization layout is being used in this customization layout. So you can change your layout accordingly. Further, this is just JavaScript plain objects for the menu items. Whatever menu items that we have used, it's just being referred here in the JavaScript objects. Next is the routes. We are using three kind of routes: authentication, login, and main route. But all those wrapped inside the one index.js, authentication routes, login routes, and main routes. So authentication routes consist all the routes related to authentication, like forgot password or register for the URL or kind of that thing, login and all those stuff. Then login route itself also considers the theme before you logged in. So if I just log out from here. So this is our login route. Whatever is here, like forgot password, those things will be the login route. And the main route is the routes after we do a login. So all the routes is being referred here or mentioned here. Further is a store. This considers the React store as reducers and actions and all this being is mentioned here to do any global change. Next is the theme folder. This is the main folder for any theme customization. I'll walk through in the separate lecture when we do a setup or a theme customization. How can you change the typography, colors, and how to override the component styles. So that is being managed here. This is the UI component. This UI components is consist of third-party component or an extended component that we have used. We have extended some of the material UI components like accordion, navbar, outer, all those stuff is being extended or mentioned here. And this is the utils. It consists of locales and root guards and XCO setup and all these things, like which are really utils, like locals is the and the root guard like auth guard and guest guard and all those stuff. So those all those settings is being inside the utils. This is the view folder. The view folder consists exit the same structure which you see in the main layout. So for instance, if I do login, so this is the UI component structure. So for instance, it is dashboard, it's a widget, it's the application. So you will see the same application, dashboard, widget, and kind of that thing. And if any subfolder or sub directory exists inside that one, for instance, dashboard, we have two dashboard, analytics and default. So you can see the same here. This is default and analytics dashboard. So we try to make it consistent with the UI so that it's easy to use, and you can directly jump onto that one. So further, this is app.js, config.js, index.js, and service worker. Index.js is the very first thing in the application, as you know, that it just loads the app component as a single source of truth, and that app component loads other things like what other things are required, like Firebase, roots, and snack bar, and navigation, all other things. So I think that's it. If you have such or some queries in the folder structure, if you find some improvements, just post it in the comment. That's it for this tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye bye.